From JBS Studios in Greater New York, this is the JBS News Update with Teisha Bader.
I'm Teisha Bader with the JBS News Update for Thursday, February the 25th, 2021. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu spoke over the phone last night with Speaker of the U.S. House of Representatives, Nancy Pelosi. Netanyahu tweeted afterwards that it was great talking with the Speaker. He wrote, "The U.S. Congress has always been a bastion of support for the unbreakable alliance between the United States and Israel." Pelosi tweeted as well yesterday, writing that she spoke with Netanyahu to reaffirm the unbreakable bond between our nations and Congress's unwavering support for a safe and secure Israel. She wrote, "We discussed COVID response and our shared hope for regional peace, including a just, stable, and enduring two-state solution." And staying with the Prime Minister, Netanyahu met this week with Egyptian Petroleum and Mineral Resources Minister Tariq El Mola in Jerusalem. He called it an important day marking Israel and Egypt's continued cooperation on energy and in a number of other areas. The Prime Minister said there is a new era of peace and prosperity for the region with the Abraham Accords. This began, of course, with the historic peace treaty between Egypt and Israel, which was signed in 1979. But now Netanyahu said it is becoming something that can better the lives of all the people in economic terms, and we think that this is a great opportunity for regional cooperation, Egypt, Israel, and the other countries. Israel's President Reuven Rivlin met with El Mola as well and tweeted that they will continue to strengthen the cooperation between the countries and the connections between our peoples in all fields. UNRWA, the United Nations Relief and Works Agency for Palestine Refugees in the Near East, is once again under fire for reportedly not fixing educational material which it subsidizes and is distributed to Palestinian school children. We had reported to you about this back in January that the materials contained anti-Israel messages, including incitement to violence, with UNRWA promising to fix the issue. But a report released this month by Impact SE, the Institute for Monitoring Peace and Cultural Tolerance in School Education, which is an Israeli watchdog group based out of Hebrew University, said the issue had not been addressed and that found materials contained incitement to violence, demonization of Israel, which was erased from maps, endorsements of jihad and martyrdom, among others. The leaders of the Conference of Presidents of Major American Jewish Organizations wrote, "It is unacceptable for such harmful and incendiary propaganda targeting a UN member state to be disseminated by a UN organization, and that UNRWA's consistent misdeeds and failure to live up to its commitment must be addressed by the international community, which is giving tacit support for incitement, violence, and Jew hatred, so long as it remains silent." The Genesis Prize Foundation announced yesterday that it will honor the life and legacy of the late Rabbi Lord Jonathan Sacks, the former British chief rabbi who passed away in November. Sacks himself was a member of the Genesis Prize Selection Committee and one of seven finalists for this year's Genesis Prize, which ultimately went to director Steven Spielberg. The prize committee called Sacks an extraordinary Jewish thinker and a moral voice for the world. The prize's foundation co-founder and chairman Stan Paulowitz said that no one in the world was as adept at explaining Judaism to both Jews and non-Jews as Lord Sacks, always emphasizing the religion's focus on justice, morality, and tolerance. "We plan to honor this great Jewish voice," Paulowitz said, "by paying tribute to his life's work and supporting the preservation of his intellectual and spiritual legacy to ensure it continues to live on for future generations." A celebration is planned for this coming November in London. Well, the Jewish festival of Purim begins this evening, commemorating the saving of the Jewish people from destruction during the ancient Persian Empire. Celebratory traditions include the giving of gifts to friends and to the poor, listening to the reading of the Megillah, the Book of Esther, and dressing up in costume. Israel's President Reuven Rivlin shared that his residence was dressing up for the holiday. In a tribute, he tweeted to Jerusalem's Mifletzet, a well-known and beloved playground sculpture in the form of a monster in the neighborhood of Kiryat Hayovel in the capital. Rivlin wrote, "We and Jerusalem municipality are hosting our own special monster here at Beit Hanasi, the president's residence, for Purim, inviting the public to come by and wishing all a happy Purim." And we have special Purim programming here on JBS for you tonight for Thursday, February the 25th. There's Talmud study at 7 o'clock, and then at 8, a Purim celebration from Central Synagogue with a Megillah reading and a musical Purim spiel this year in a 1980s-inspired virtual program. At 9, Mark Golub sits down with veteran comedian Jackie Mason on L'Chaim, followed by Jackie Mason on Broadway in the 1988 special The World According to Me. At 10:30, a L'Chaim with Judy Gold, who talks about her Jewish background and her work as a comedian. And coming up next, Rabbi Mark Schneier speaks on the meaning of Purim, which is followed by a full Megillah reading by Rabbi Avraham Bronstein, pre-recorded from the Hampton Synagogue with on-screen Hebrew transcription and English translation. And that's the JBS News Update for Thursday, February the 25th, 2021. I'm Teisha Bader. Stay healthy, stay well, and Chag Sameach.